Host leading the Jew, 1-0.
Oh, no, it's not a contest. But anyway, how do you get back?
You just start in with clubs, Tom. You know, I came out of the service. I went to the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, which the American Academy of Dramatic Arts keeps quiet, because I'm a graduate of the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, and they don't talk about it too much.
No, they don't.
When they have a big affair in New York, they always ask me to be the MC, but when it comes to any awards or running ads, don't say him, don't mention that. He graduated from the American Academy. I went with Jason Robards, Anne Bancroft, and Grace Kelly, and a lot of big people that became very successful. And I went along there, and the director said, this man is eating up the sets. Because I had a lot of energy. I used to overact like crazy. Now I'm completely calm and relaxed.
Right, exactly. Ah!
But, you know, in those days, so I went to the American Academy, and that was a big help to me, because it gave me some security and a little prestige, you know. Mm-hmm. You know, at 20-some-odd years old, 22, 23 years old, you know, it's great to be at American Academy of Dramatic Arts.
You know, I was watching a couple of weekends ago, Carson's got this set of cassettes out with all the great moments from The Tonight Show. Mm. And you're in there several times, most notably the night that he's in the geisha house with the swimming pool.
That was so
oh, what a night. I know that you and he are pals, and I know you must remember those days very, very fondly.
Oh,
and,
yeah, Carson was.
Jesus, you guys were funny together.
Well, he set you up, Tom, you know, like you do in a way, you do. He made it, like he listened, and he made you funny. If you had any ability with Johnny, he was a great setup artist. Mm-hmm. He would sit back and then wait for his shots, and he'd get some good rippers off, believe me.
Oh, yeah.
But it was fun to be with him when you were on the show, because you never knew what was going to happen. We'd have 40 million notes, and none of that was ever discussed. It was just right off the top of what you got, right, the cream, right off the can you know.
So anyway, you're off now to Honolulu and China.
Not
with
Honolulu.
Or Hong Kong.
What's the matter?
I got the first.
Travel agent? Honolulu. Think I want to go there and suck on fire all day long?
I'll bet you'll stop there for an hour and then go on.
No, we don't go to Honolulu. We don't go that way. We go to Tokyo.
And you're going with the Newharts. Now, what is
They're
it like
going with me?
What is it like being with Bob Newhart on tour, on vacation?
Well, he's a very bright man, very educated. Mm-hmm. He always reminds me of his education. Graduated Loyola and all that baloney, you know, an accountant.
Yeah, right.
You know, and I had trouble in school, you know. I was the only guy during the test, you know, when you had the regent test or whatever you call it.
Yeah,
regents.
That's good.
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
Something like that. And I was always the one like, and the teacher said, what are you doing? He said, cheating.
Cheating.
You're not allowed to do that. Pardon me, what's the fourth answer? Oh, good. And we have a great relationship because our basic values, as he says, the wives are key. Barbara's my wife, Barbara, God bless her.
And Ginny.
His wife, Ginny, bless her. They're both alike, you know. They sit around and they go, listen, boys, we're going to go shopping. And we sit in the room and go, oh, God almighty. And they come back and it's a big tab. But the thing of it is that we both have the same values, we laugh at the same things, and we're different, but yet we're not, if that makes sense. And it's very hard to find somebody you could travel around the world with, and we've gone on many trips.
I know you have.
And really enjoy each
but
other.
But then you do stuff to him, like you told me in the restaurant what you did to him one time.
In the restaurant?
When you call the waiter.
Oh, yeah. Well, those are things. You know, Bob, he hates that word, low-key. He's not really low-key, but his image is, you know, like, he likes it quiet.
He's quiet.
You know,
he's very quiet.
And I do like, we'll be sitting in a restaurant. We were in Munich, Germany, and I would go, Carl, is dinner going to be served? And he'd go, don't do that. It's not funny, and they're going to throw us out. Don't. I'd say, Bob, what's the matter? He said, well, just order nice. Waiter! Don't stop it. Stop it with the waiter, no matter what we do. And then we're walking down the street in Munich. You don't have these big streets with no cars.
Oh, sure, yeah.
The big
promenades.
Yeah. And we're walking down, and I, one day, just for laughs, walked down and went, lovely area here.
Oh, and you're doing the goose step.
Yeah, and I was doing like that, and he went, why are you doing that? I said, I got cramps in my legs. He said, well, don't do that. They're not going to think it's funny. I said, Bob, what am I doing? And the man took his umbrella and tried to hit me. But we have a lot of fun together, we do. And I'm looking forward to it. It's our 30th anniversary. I'm married 30 years.
Wow.
Thanks a million for the gift.
Thanks a million for your
ad. I said 30 years, and you went, oh, okay.
I was about to congratulate you.
Well, you saw my wife. She's not bad. And then not great, not bad.
And then you took the shot, and I was going to say thanks for sending me your address so I could send you the gift.
I know what you're going to say.
That's like the night you
said. One of the Tom Snyder coffee cups.
Yeah, it's like the night you said to me, join us for dinner if you can find my house. I know all these things.
Yeah, well, you know, you can't handle a dinner with us, Tom. You're strictly, you know, coffee and a burger.
Let's get out of here while we're ahead, pal.
Oh, gee. It's been a long night, Tom.
I know that you're playing the Jupiter Theater in Florida on April 11th through the 16th.
Right.
When is the picture Casino coming out?
They say Thanksgiving.
Oh, good.
Yeah, and it's really great. I mean, I can't say enough about it. Joe Pesci, Jimmy Woods is in it, and Kevin Pollak. There's some great performers in it. And, of course, I'm in it. And when I'm on the screen, the whole thing comes to life.
Comes to life.
Yeah, yeah. Otherwise, it's a downer. But, right. You know, and Scorsese keeps walking around going, I'm Marty Scorsese. And I give him a cookie and he goes away. He's real penny, you know. But, you know.
Many thanks, my friend. I hope I see you off-screen often, and I hope that when the picture's about to come out, you'll come back and speak with us again.
Thanks.
I think the world of you and your wife, you know that, and you're always, always welcome.
Thanks, Tom. And if I may say, I really mean it. I'm delighted you're back on doing this kind of show, and it's your ball game, and you do a hell of a job, really. And good luck to you, really, Tom. And take care of yourself. And I did speak to the clinic a year, tops. What a turnout you're going to get. I figure you've got 40 cars. And I'm going to do the eulogy. Father, may I say a word even though I'm a Jew? Please, Father. Yes, my boy, say a few words.
Just let me know when you're through, pal.
Yeah, it's over, Tom.
Sure is.
You're going to linger just to bother people.
Get him. Leave him be. We'll be right back after these messages.
What a lousy show.